Howdy there, all you cum guzzlers and connoisseurs of wood, both light and heavy and, well, let's just say porous and other. Okay, Scott Grove here, GroovyMusicLessons.com, Dr. Groovy. Anyway, got some morons that, well, there's always morons, aren't there? People who, for some reason, have been sending me little propaganda and stuff, showing me different kinds of woods, and this one here had this lovely display of the pores on the side of the woods when you cut the boards in half, multiply it by 10 times zoom, and if it has really porous wood, then it's supposed to be warmer sounding. Okay, so we all know all this bullshit is bullshit. And at the very bottom, you know, it went through, it said, okay, here's the mahogany that Gibson uses, and here's all the way down to the basswood. No, it is not basswood. I know that, well, what was that moron used to work for a Premier guitar doing the interviews with Rebecca Dirks. Yeah, and here's the, well, that's made out of basswood. No, it's basswood, people. Gotta know your woods. Anyway, and it said down here on the bottom of this particular piece, the basswood is made for crappy guitars over in China, blah, 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 blah. Actually, basswood is amazing wood. And the only thing it doesn't have is a wood grain pattern. It's just very light. It is meant to be painted over. It is very great to work with. You know, you get some of these harder woods and they are just a pain to work with. And is basswood cheap? It can be and it can't be. It depends, finally, at the end of the day, on the whatever guitar you get made at the end of it. Doesn't matter the woods. Some woods don't cost any more than the basswood does, but they're going to charge you for it because you'll pay it. Let me just show you something really quick, and I'll get out of your hair, and you can get off my ass. All right. What I'm going to do is just show you a couple guitars here and tell you the weight of them. I'm trying to see what the hell I can see on here. Got the scale in here. Okay. There we go. So right here's our scale. There's going to be the weight. Here's the scale itself. I'm trying to get it all in there. I'll get there. I am. All right. Okay. So let's go with just a flat out, just to show you this, mahogany all the way through, which is why I couldn't use the Les Paul, because they have that maple cap on them. So I'm going to use this Gibson Explorer. It's mahogany body and mahogany neck and rosewood fingerboard. Okay, these are actually much lighter than Les Pauls. Okay, so here's a 1976 Explorer. I'm going to turn on the old scale here. It's going to pop up here, and I will put the guitar on the scale, and let's see what we got. We have, see if you can read that. Sorry, I suck at this, but hey, it's what it is. There you go. Told you I suck at this. 8 pounds, 14 ounces. All right. I can leave it there and zoom it back out. 8 pounds, 14 ounces on mahogany and mahogany. Okay, now I'm going to grab the next guitar, which is a Paul Reed Smith. And it's made out of solid mahogany as well. Mahogany body, mahogany neck, rosewood fingerboard. Exactly the same as the last one. Okay, here we go. Got our scale there. Put it on here. Da-da-da. Love these guitars. You'll see why. Da-da-da. 5 pounds, 10 ounces. Now that is a guitar to play right there. Okay. Not all guitars are made from the same tree, people. Rosewood is not just rosewood. Mahogany is not just mahogany. Basswood is not just basswood. Okay, so there are many things to consider. Okay, that first guitar that I showed you, I paid like $7,000 for. That one down there, I paid $300 for. Okay, made out of the exact same materials. One was just lighter than the other one. That one's a much better guitar, the $300 guitar is. Okay, these guitars. Let's see if you can even see it. I don't know. But anyway, it's the James Burton USA, that custom shop Telecasters with the flames on them and stuff. If you get them with the flames on them, these cool things. From Musician's Friend, right now they're going for $1,700. If you get them in white, they go for $2,200. Yes, you know, $500 extra for white. Serious. Okay, now, okay, so again, $1,700, Musician's Friend or Guitar or whatever the hell that place is, Guitar Center. So that's what they go for, brand new. And guess what? Yes, 100% basswood. Yep, one of the most amazing Fenders ever built. So we have 100% basswood body. We have lace sensors. We have the maple neck with the maple fingerboard. Okay, let's check it out on the old scale here. So basswood. Okay, what do we got? We're looking at 7 pounds, 15.6 ounces, so 8 pounds. Okay, basswood, 8 pounds and nearly $2,000, and then actually $2,200 if you want it in white. Basswood, basswood, basswood. It paints up amazingly. Don't think so? Yeah, there's my axe that I had made. What is it? Why would I be picking it up? Again, is the other one, bolt on. And yes, the other two, the mahoganies were both set necks and everything was exactly the same. Again, basswood, maple neck, maple fingerboard. Lace sensors again, so the pickups weigh the same. Okay, okay, basswood. The last one was what, 8 pounds? Okay, here comes mine. Get in there, Scott. There you go, kids. 6 pounds, 10.7 ounces. So, the other one was much healthier. So this is very light. Okay, so there you go. And this one cost $2,500. Basswood. It is amazing, amazing stuff. So just because you see in little catalogs that you can buy crappy BC Rich guitars that are made in China out of basswood, that doesn't mean that, it doesn't mean anything actually. It just means you can buy the guitar for that price. But then again, other basswood guitars, yeah, they're coming straight out of the custom shops, and it's just a fine, fine wood to make guitars out of. And again, if you're paying big money for some other kind of wood that you think is scarce, do a little bit of research, because these really expensive woods aren't that expensive, and basswood is amazing. So anybody who doesn't believe that, no hope for you. Either that or just go do some studying, that's all I got to say. So once again, Scott Grove, groovymusiclessons.com. Just wanted to show you that the same kind of woods, the exact same kind of woods, are lumped together as basswood, and that's it. Some basswood trees sections don't weigh as much as others. I specifically said how much I wanted mine to weigh, and they found a piece that would cut down and weigh less than anything else. And this mahogany thing, Paul Reed Smith, what, 5 pounds? All mahogany, exactly the same as all Gibson Flying V's, Explorers, everything else. Mahogany, mahogany, mahogany. Paul Reed Smith for $300, all the exact same things as what Gibson puts out. It's the same mahogany. Yes, there are 3,000 gazillion varieties of mahogany. Same with the rosewood on the necks and so on the fingerboards, I'm sorry. So many different species, but yeah, if you're paying a whole lot of money for a special kind of wood, you really need to have your head examined. And again, this is in defense of the moron who sent me the pictures of the basswood and saying how crappy it was. So again, a couple of $2,000 guitars plus minus a couple pennies. Yes, basswood is wonderful. If you ever get a chance to work with any of you actual guitar builders, I'm not going to say luthiers anymore because they're two totally different people. So if you are an actual builder instead of a person who does setup work, then yeah, work with some basswood, man. It's amazing. It paints great. It's so easy to work with. The CNC machines, they're going to love them. If you use your routers or anything, whatever you use, you're going to love it. It's definitely harder than the pine stuff, you know, so just a great wood. And again, you can have it as heavy as you want or as light as you want. Just pick a tree, any tree. Later.